to our channel, and today we are going to learn how to create templates in SOLIDWORKS. It's the first part of the video. It explains about the how to create part template using the SOLIDWORKS software. Before going to the tutorial, you have to just learn what is template and what are the uses, and then we will see how to create it using SOLIDWORKS software. Let's begin. What is a part template? Part template is a SOLIDWORKS document which helps to provide a basic and particular format and properties for particular design work. For example, you can create one part template with ISO dimensioning standard and another with ANSI, the American standard. Also, one with the millimeter unit and measurement, and another with inch measure. Like that, you can create part templates with different document properties and will help you to design models with pre-set requirements. We can open the template and make your design without thinking about the document properties and styles. So let's begin to create part template. This is the SOLIDWORKS 2016 user main user interface. And to create a part file, you can go to the file and click new, or you can go to the main toolbar or click new button. Here you can see the part option. Just select it and click OK. Wait for the document to create in the SOLIDWORKS. This is the default part file template. We have to edit the document properties like measurement units and styles, material properties, etc. You have to enter it in the part document. So for that, you have to go to the options, click on that, it will directly go to the system options. You have to select the document properties tab. Here we have to set the standard, the drafting standard, as ANSI. If you want to prefer to make it as ISO standard, here I am selecting ISO. For just for example, annotations, you can edit the types of arrows you want. If you want it like that, you can do this like it. Dimensions, fonts, you can select the particular font for the showing. I'm saying Century School Book. Okay, can other grid and snap, you can measure grid spacing, you can change it if you want. The another thing is unit. Here I am making with millimeter. The all units are in millimeter with two decimals. You can select the decimal rounding option also here, around half towards zero. Okay, another thing is you can select the material properties. You can enter the density of the material here. It depends upon your design. You can also select the image quality. You can adjust it, the image quality, the displayed image quality, and all like that. You can set the document style, and there is click OK to apply these styles. And once you set the styles, you have to save it as a part template. For that, go to the save button in main toolbar, click save as. Here you can enter the name part template 1 and select the save as type as the part template .prtdot, that is the extension. Just save it. Okay, now your part template is saved. Here you can see the part template 1, the whatever opens in it, it will show. We can just test the unit in it. Yes. Okay, smart dimension. See, it's looks in millimeters that we already set it in the part template one. Okay, we will close this part template. Let's see. And how to select this template for your next drawing or next design? Go to the main standard toolbar and click new button. And this is a default part template. You have to access the new template. Go to the advanced, and here is your part template one. Just select it and click OK. Now your part template is created, and the measurement unit is millimeter, and or can also check the document properties here, the ISO modified, like that. It will changes like that, and units, the millimeter as you set it earlier, and this way we have to create the part template. I think you could understand about how to create a part template, how to save it, and how to access it for your next drawing or model design. So if you like my video, please feel free to like and subscribe it for getting new video tutorials, and please also give your valuable comments. It's important for us to improve ourselves in videos and to give valuable information to others. And thank you. Bye bye.